What's up, dudes? It's me, Ren, and welcome to a little anime rambles video where I speak my mind about anime and, like, I'm not really sure if this will be a reoccurring theme in my speed paints because I need specific topics to cover from animes, but some of y'all liked it when I talked about a series that I feel strongly about, just like the Banana Fish video. So in this video, I'll be talking about Attack on Titan, since it's been the talk of the town and the final season is finally airing, and I have some thoughts from the mixed reviews it's receiving. Also, I'm not using my microphone, my studio microphone, I'm just using my iPad because I'm too lazy. So forgive me with the quality. I just want to put this out there that I haven't watched season 3 yet as of recording this because I've been reading the manga more. Well, actually, I've only read the mangas of the series airing this year, like Jujutsu Kaisen and other series. That's because I'm too lazy to watch online, so just reading the manga is better. Plus, I can analyze dialogues more than watching and don't have to pause every 15 seconds. So I'm pretty up to date to Attack on Titan, and oh boy. Also, quick disclaimer, I might be talking about some minor spoilers, so listen at your own risk if you don't want to be spoiled. Alright, so season 4 just aired with the first episode, and lo and behold, it was from a new studio. Which studio is MAPPA? MAPPA is one of my favorite studios, as they did Dorohedoro, Banana Fish, Dororo, You're an Ice, and The Great Pretender. We all know Attack on Titan started because of Studio Wit, but I know what y'all thinking. Why they switched to a different studio when it's the final season? You see, this wasn't a last-minute decision. Based on my resources, this was planned way back in 2018, I believe, for reasons that Wit may want to focus more on a different production. Plus, the different studios they asked to do the finale either declined or did not want to take the responsibility, except for MAPPA. I've seen a lot of posts circulating on the internet, mostly on Twitter, about people's concern about MAPPA taking over. Before the finale aired, the trailer and promotional posters were posted. Some complained that the style isn't like how Wit did before and has more use of CGI on their animations, and I get that. I know what they're feeling, but sometimes you gotta take advantage of today's modern technology. But people also complained about the art style, which, first of all, I respect MAPPA's production because they stick to their source materials, aka the manga. Take Jujutsu Kaisen and Banana Fish, for example. They stay true to the manga art style, so you gotta give MAPPA some credit at least. They set the mood as well, so since the setting is now, or the arc is now, gonna be in more of a war zone, so in all honesty, I really don't care about the art style so much as long as they can deliver the storyline, and then I'm Gucci. Of course, I will never thank Wit enough for their services for bringing Attack on Titan to life. Y'all should be grateful we're getting a season finale. Like, sit your asses down, enjoy the series, or read the manga. Like, stop complaining. Now let's move on to the opening song. The amount of complaints people made about this is ridiculous. People were saying it sucks, or going as far as saying it's romanticizing war. And I'm just like, bruh. How in the hell is that romanticizing the fuck? Okay, these complaints mostly come from anime watchers. I can understand that, which I'll give the benefit of the doubt and let that slide a bit or a little. But boy, when I watched that opening and ending for the first time, it gave me fucking chills. It gave me goosebumps. The visuals in the opening reminded me of Dorohedoro, which MAPPA worked also on. People don't know this, but if you're a manga reader, the opening pretty much gave so much hints and foreshadowing on this finale and on what will take place. Take for example the quote, children picking up their coins, something along those lines, but yeah, y'all don't know how sad this part of the lyric felt like. Oh my god, I will never forget that moment. that was so sad. Also, the repeat of like monster, monster, monster. I know I'm not a singer, but like, yeah, you get what I mean. At the end part of the opening, while zooming in into Eren's Attack on Titan form, I mean, Attack Titan form, pretty much sums up what's happening in the manga and would be happening in the finale. In the ending, it mostly focuses of the warriors, more specifically Falco, which in all honesty has a major role in the current arc. And when I saw the opening and ending, I realized that, oh my god, it's, of course it's MAPPA. They pretty much have the reputation of dropping hints in the opening ending, like for example, Banana Fish. So in conclusion, the opening and ending was perfect for the current arc. Plus I have the opening on loop. I really need the full version on Spotify, like please. Anyways, I saw a lot of people complaining about Where's Eren, and I'm just like, it's only episode one. Y'all need to chill, because if Eren shows up already, it ruins the story, basically. Plus, y'all get your crumb soon, so be patient, because it will soon be worth it. Little is to know about the total number of episodes in this finale, but people are saying it's 16, which I don't know if it's possible, but it might work, who knows, but I can't confirm it. But do let me know in the comments, because I swear to god, if they release a fucking movie as the final, I lose my fucking shit, because you have to wait for it to air the next year after it airs with subs and etc. So as a manga reader, what scenes do I look forward to that should be animated? I'm not sure if it would reach these parts of the manga, but I can't wait for the Ymir history of the founding titan, Pike, Peak. Eren's man bum. Levi versus Zeke again. Armin talking to Annie and Annie's release, the rumbling if it ever reaches to that part of the manga, and also more of the memories of the founding titan because of Eren's manipulation. And the things I'm not looking forward to are the character deaths, which I know y'all know who I'm referring to. Rest in peace. So yeah, that's my thoughts and rambles about the finale of Attack on Titan. Here is a finished piece of Eren. Honestly, I have a love and hate relationship on Eren's character development and his intentions for causing the rumbling. But yeah, let me know your thoughts on the finale in the comments section. And also, just a quick little thing, I hope you could follow me on my other social media accounts. You can check those in the description. And please like and subscribe, even though I never say this in all my videos, but please. I never thought this would actually mean something, so here we are. Don't worry, I won't be saying this much in every video, so feel free to follow me or not. I don't really know. Also, like this video, I guess. Yeah, and again, just enjoy the series, okay? Stop complaining. Be thankful we have this animated. So yeah, till next time. Bye.